everybody. Thanks for coming tonight. I know there's a lot of things going on around town this weekend. A lot of surfers running amok and little parties going on everywhere. So really appreciate everybody coming out and to celebrate Janine's latest body of work. And Janine's work, I mean, I'm a woodworker, not a art specialist or anything, but I love Janine's work. It's full of themes of love, fun and life, you know. There's so much going on in them. I know the first time my young daughter Emily saw her work, she just attached herself straight away to a couple of the paintings because she could see her own little love life going on in there. And I'm sure if you look at all the work, you'll see little parts of your own life in some paintings, not others, you know. But it's easy to connect to Janine's work, and it's colourful and it's fun and it's very well executed. You know, I know enough about art to know what good art is, and Janine's work is very good art. So we're stoked to get Janine on board. Like I say, we really appreciate Janine being here, and I'm going to pass you over to Janine to talk a little bit about her work and go for your life, Janine.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you. I'm getting directed now. No, thank you all for coming, and thank you guys for having me again and after 6 years. This body, I've been painting full time for about 20 years, and I've run a constant theme through my work is I like to celebrate living life with your heart on your sleeve, about living in the moment, which is very trendy at the moment if you're into mindful living, but about sort of living, trying to be where you are at that time and be present and open to the love and the friendship that people give to you so that you can also give that back. In this particular body of work we talked about what it is about Margaret River that's so captivating, and it's very similar to Wilson's Promontory in Melbourne. There's a similar kind of feeling and where I live in the peninsula, there's lots of wineries, great restaurants, a lot of art and culture. And I think that the Margaret River reflects that. So to me, it's quite like coming home. Some years ago, when I was 21, and I was madly, deeply in love with a young man, I had never been to Margaret River. I didn't even know how to drive, because going to art school was no point, because I couldn't afford a car anyway. So we bought an $800 old Holden Commodore station wagon and drove from Melbourne across the Nullarbor, where I learned to drive and nearly killed us a few times. But ended up down here in Perth and down at Margaret River for 3 months we spent just going to all the different beaches, and it was very different back then. Like, you know, there was wineries, but that wasn't the big thing. It was a really surfy hangout kind of layback place. So a lot of the stories that I've got in here are memories that I've got of being madly, deeply in love and exploring a part of the beach and life that I hadn't done before, great freedom, but then I had to come back because my mum told me I had a job, which was a bit disappointing. But so enjoy this piece of body of work. If there's any pieces you want to talk about or anything that you're interested in, just let me know. But thank you all for coming, and enjoy.
Just before we let Janine escape, has anybody got any questions about Janine's work at all? I don't want to put you on the spot, but you know, sometimes you've seen a painting or you just might have a question to fire up Janine.
Questions are good.
Question time, you know. So the floor's open, here's your chance. And you get to hear about every three years or so, not very often.
Janine?
Yes.
Could you explain every one of your paintings has the asymmetrical face?
Yes.
And I just wonder what is it that you're thinking of when you portray a face that way?
Faces in my work have been had many coins of phrase. One was, oh, she's the girl who paints people with their heads on the side. Or
I think that's fine.
But I kind of look at how we relate to people, and I think that there's the storyteller and the muse. So to me, in most of those paintings, I have one larger eye. And that's normally the eye, what I call, these are my little metaphors, nobody has to care about these, but that's the eye of contact, that's the conversation that I'm having with you is directed to you, so you're listening to me, and that's where the head on the side and the asymmetrical head thing happens. They've changed and evolved over many years. Sometimes people call them, they look like almonds, some people say they look like donuts, whatever, but it's the story to me is that to be living in the moment is to actually let people speak and you listen as well. So that's kind of where the faces come from.
Good. That's great to know.
Good question, though.
Well, it's just such a common theme through the whole of your work.
Yeah, basically the people or characters, as one calls them in my work, I've been painting for 20 years, and I found these people one day when I was working in my head, and they've just allowed me to tell every story I've wanted to say. So, and I love it. And I think a lot of people now kind of recognise that as a symbol of my work, and they kind of can read themselves into it as well.
Yeah. Very good. Anyone else? No, if there's no further questions, it's time to drink wine and buy
art. Yes, enjoy.
Enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Use the opportunity to shine. You don't want to ask in front of a crowd. Janine's here.
Yes, thank you.